You know, with all the choices of anti-hyperglycemic medications for people with type 2 diabetes, it's important, of course, to be able to individualize therapy, and in particular to look at the patient profile and see whether or not certain medications are more effective, less effective, safe in these specific populations. In particular, we've been focusing on people over the age of 65. There are a number of reasons that we do that. First, people over 65 tend to have other medical conditions. They may be taking other medications. And importantly, a large proportion of them, close to 50%, have mild renal insufficiency or stage 2 chronic kidney disease. So we performed a study which was actually published and presented here at ADA last year, where we looked at sitagliptin compared to dapagiflozin, an SGLT2 inhibitor, in patients who had mild renal insufficiency. In that study, the primary analysis showed that sitagliptin was both non-inferior and superior to dapagiflozin, and had a safety and tolerability profile, which was, you know, both were very comparable. In this analysis, which we've presented here at ADA, we've specifically looked at the population in that study who were over 65 years of age. They comprised about two-thirds of the population, so it was a very robust study to look at this issue. And in this post-hoc analysis, what we saw in the older population was a very similar efficacy profile to what was seen in the primary study. Sitagliptin and dapagiflozin, you know, both were effective at lowering A1C. You know, numerically, sitagliptin provided a little bit more A1C lowering than dapagiflozin. The safety and tolerability profiles were comparable. There was a slightly higher rate of drug-related adverse experiences with dapagiflozin, but that was primarily driven by genital mycotic infections, which is common with the class. So what are the implications of the study? I mean, I think, you know, clearly as the population is getting older and the prevalence of diabetes is higher, you know, in people as they get older, it's important to have studies that specifically focus on the profile for patients. And so we think this post-hoc analysis adds to the database regarding the choices of antihyperglycemics for older individuals.